Exactly 50 years ago today is one of those days Kenyans would rather forget, but the cold reality is that we have no say on destiny. A memorial service is underway at the Holy Basilica, Nairobi, to mark the 50th anniversary of Argwings Kodhek's death and a wreath-laying ceremony at his Malanga home in Jhem on Saturday. Below, Carole Argwings Kodhek on her father's death and what separated CGM from the rest of the pack. On Tuesday of January 29, 1969, Kenya's Minister for Foreign Affairs Clement Michael George Argwings Kodhek's car rolled on the Nairobi road that is now named after him. He was rushed to Nairobi Hospital where he died hours later. 50 years later, his firstborn Carole Argwings Kodhek remembers the week that death took away CMG, as he was fondly called, the positive corruption of the initials being Jdo Mor Jhem, Dolio for the cream of Jhem. You had to be the creme de la creme if you graduated with a law degree in 1947 and was the first black lawyer in East Africa, which is what CMG did. On a normal day after schools had opened for the first term in 1969, Carole, now a travel writer, was in class in Mary Hill School, Thika. Father had died a few days earlier, but on an account of her tender age, she wasn't informed immediately. I remember coming out of class. People were looking at me funnily, she recalls. The only thought racing through her mind was something being wrong with her uniform. A sense of deja vu set in when she was summoned to Sister Superior's office. I was really scared, wondering what is going on, she recalls. Her mother had died a few months ago, so she was still tensed up as an inner voice told her it had to be something to do with her dad, but Mother Superior was not revealing anything. Carole, we have to take you to Nairobi. All other children are there already and you need to come, said Mother Superior at last. At home, there were people everywhere,